Hey, it's Coach Justin from Ultimate Baseball Training, and in today's video, I'm going to share with you a cool little fun hitting drill that you can start adding to your practice routine right now today that's going to instantly help you hit for more power. So let's just get straight into it. So I think in terms of adding power at the plate, I think there's two major things that a lot of hitters really need to focus on. And that's what we're gonna discuss in this video, and that's what this drill is gonna help you do. So the first major key is separation between my upper and my lower body. So what I mean by that is what I just did there, okay? When I go into my load and my stride and my swing, we have to have as much separation as we can get between our upper body staying sort of, whatever you want to call it, closed or coiled back like this. We need to have our upper body coiled back while our lower half begins violently rotating this way, okay? That's what generates that bat speed, is that separation between your upper body and your lower body. And I think the best analogy to use when describing separation is just the rubber band example that I always give. And so imagine a rubber band is between these two fingers right here, okay? If we're talking about getting the most out of that rubber band and really having it explode as fast as possible, then it comes down to the separation that I'm able to get between my two fingers, right? The more that I separate these two fingers and pull them apart, the more that rubber band stretches, the more separation the rubber band has, and then the more energy it has built up to then explode, right? And you've obviously stretched a rubber band to its limit, and then all of a sudden it explodes, right? And it breaks. Well, the same can be said for your baseball swing, right? The more separation that you get between your upper and lower body, just think of that rubber band example, the more energy you're gonna have to explode on the baseball. All right, and the second thing that you need to master is driving through the baseball and not stopping at contact. And this is a common issue that I see with a lot of younger players. They do a lot of things really well in their swing. They get into a great launch position, which, as I've talked about in the past, I think is very important to being a great hitter, right? You have to get into a great launch position, but I see a lot of players who do that. But then for whatever reason, you know, everything looks good until the point of contact. Heck, even sometimes at the point of contact, hitters look good, but then it's immediately after contact something happens. With a lot of younger hitters, they're maybe not strong enough to really drive all the way through the baseball. So you almost see them at the point of contact almost doing like a recoil. Their bat like hits the ball and then pops back, right? A recoil like this. A lot of times you'll see that, or you'll see them actually make contact with the ball, but immediately after they just roll their wrist like this and get really flippy like this. So obviously we want to avoid those things. We're going to have better bat speed. We're definitely going to have more power if instead of stopping at contact or having a recoil at contact, if we drive through the baseball and get to a great extension position. So I think if you can work on those two things, first of all, getting more separation in your swing, and then working on, instead of stopping at contact, driving through the baseball, if we work on those two things, we're gonna really be able to add a lot of power quickly and easily. So here's what you're gonna need for this drill. You're gonna need your regular batting tee. You're gonna need a flat soccer ball like this one, or a flat basketball will work as well. And then optional, might come in handy, you're gonna need a plunger, because a plunger, you can stick it upside down in your tee, and then the ball actually sits on the plunger a lot easier than it does on the tee. Sometimes, you know, it'll fall off the tee, especially if you have any sort of wind or something like that. But you're probably thinking, well, I've done this drill before, hitting a flat soccer ball or basketball off of a tee, right? But you probably haven't done it this way, so let me show you how it works. Instead of putting a regular baseball on a tee, you're gonna put that flat basketball or that flat soccer ball. And instead of aligning yourself the way you normally would, about right here, to hit balls off the tee, what you're actually going to do is you're going to take a couple steps backward, okay? We're going to start with a narrow stance, and I really like to start with the handle of my bat kind of on my neck and knob facing the catcher, because when we get to our launch position, that's a similar position that we want to be into, okay? So we're going to start with our feet pretty narrow. And this is similar to the walkthrough drill or the walk-up drill if you've done that in the past, but we're gonna work on really getting great separation and work on driving through the baseball. That's the purpose of the heavier ball. All right, so my feet are narrow. I'm in my ready position here. The first step I want you to make is with a step behind. So I'm a right-handed hitter, my right foot behind here like this. I think that if you step in front, it's too easy to kind of leave your hips open like this and not truly close yourself off, okay? So I personally prefer if you step behind. That might mean your left foot scooting forward just a little bit in front of your right foot, okay? But your first step is gonna be that right one behind, boom. And as we go into this, that's our stride phase, and we get into our good launch position, okay? So it's kind of one step behind, then we gather our weight, gather our momentum, and we go into our load and our stride, get into a good launch position, and then from there, that's when we execute our swing. We wanna make sure, again, that we're not stopping at contact, that we're driving all the way through the ball. But the soccer ball or that flat basketball, that'll provide immediate feedback on whether or not you stopped the contact or you truly drove through the ball. So this is the drill. That's why I love this particular drill, because it combines not only, you know, the walkthrough drill, that's great for rhythm and timing and all that and working on your separation, but we need to work on separation and driving through the ball. That's where the flat soccer ball or flat basketball comes into play. So it's a great drill. It's a lot of fun. Again, it provides immediate feedback, and we're working on so many different things. We're working on our rhythm, working on our tempo, working on getting into a great launch position, right? Getting that separation between my lower body and my upper body, getting some length in this front arm here, knob facing the catcher, right? And we go through our swing, boom, and we don't just stop there. We want to drive through the ball. We want to focus on hitting that bigger ball in the middle of the field. Stay in the middle of the field. Try not to pull it too much. Try not to hit it oppo too much. Stay in the middle of the field. So I really hope you like this drill. Try it out, add it to your routine. I promise you, it's gonna boost your bat speed and your power. And if you want a few more drills just like this, designed specifically to boost your bat speed, which is gonna result in more power, then what I want you to do is grab my free bat speed workout, okay? It's 100% free. All you have to do is click on the link in the first comment. I'll leave the link in that comment. I'll pin that comment for you, so you can just scroll down right underneath this video and do that right now. And then just follow the instructions on that page once you click that link, and I'll get you this free bat speed workout, okay? So go ahead and do that right now. If you liked this drill, leave me a like on this video. I'd really appreciate that. If you have any ideas for future videos, things you'd like to see, some questions you may have about the game of baseball, leave them in the comment section below. And if you haven't joined our UBT family yet, be sure to hit that subscribe button, okay? Subscribe and turn your notifications on. We're coming out with new baseball videos every single week, and I don't want you to miss any of them. So hit that subscribe button. Thank you so much for watching today's video, and until next time, I'm out.